Computing the Standard Deviation. For example, Mr. Scott wanted to know whether the use of calculators on a test would help improve math scores. He sampled 12 of his students. The following scores were obtained. What was the standard deviation of the test scores? Since we have a sample of 12 test scores, we are going to compute the sample standard deviation. If, for example, we had a set of all test scores, we would compute the population standard deviation. So in order to compute the sample standard deviation, we must first compute the sample variance. Recall, the formula for the sample variance is the following. S squared is equal to the sum of the quantity of the deviations squared all over n minus 1. And recall, the formula for the sample standard deviation is the square root of the sample variance. Therefore, S is equal to the square root of S squared. To use the formula, we must first calculate the mean and determine the squared deviations. The mean from this example was determined to be 83.83. Next, we're going to determine the deviations, and the deviations are found by taking each observation minus the mean. So in order to figure these out, I am going to make a table by first listing the actual observations and then also listing a column for the deviations. And we'll have a third column for the squared deviations later. So the list of observations were as follows: 90, 92, 87, 83, 80, 81, 86, 85, 81, 68, 87, and 86. And in order to get the deviations, we're going to take each x value minus the mean. So 90 minus 83.83 is 6.17. 92 minus 83.83 is 8.17. And you'll continue this process until all of the deviations are listed. Now that we know the deviations, we are going to square them. And so our third column will be the squared deviations. And in order to find these values, you just simply square the deviations that we just found. So 6.17 squared is 38.0689. And 8.17 squared is 66.7489. And again, you'll repeat this process by simply squaring all of the deviations. Using this information, we can now plug these values into the formula. So I'm simply going to rewrite the formula so that we can see it on this screen. In the numerator, we have the sum of basically the squared deviations. And so in order to simplify the numerator, we need to take each squared deviation and add them together. And so this results in a value of 417.6668. And so we'll place this value into the numerator. And for the denominator, we have n minus 1. So recall there were 12 observations. And then we'll simplify the numerator into the denominator even further. And so our sample variance is 37.97. And so again, now that we know the variance, we can determine the standard deviation by simply taking the square root of it. And the square root of 37.97 is 6.16.